sinister to it. Pendulum swinging slow, a degenerate moving through the city with criminal stealth. Welcome to enemy turf, harder than immigrants work. Golf is distant in my shirt. Get up off the pavement, brush the dirt up off my psyche.
I always make it a point when I do my videos that I look my best and I feel my best, and that I just am spot on with everything that I'm saying, and everything's on point. And today I'm just kind of winging it, if that was not an indicator. And I'm doing a video that I've wanted to do for a while, mainly because I get this question a lot, and I want to have a definitive answer for people that ask me this question. So I will never, ever, ever get this question ever again. Question is, have you tested Herald of Perfection Spirits, and how good is it, and why don't you play Herald of Perfection Spirits? It's a very easy question to answer, because yes, I have. I've played all the variants of spirits, even ones that people have never heard of, like Tefnuit Spirits. Herald of Perfection Spirits is probably the best way to play Herald of Perfection, but it's probably not the most ideal way to play spirits in any format. I've always been more of a fan of the rank 4 builds or anti-meta builds of spirits as opposed to other builds. Herald of Perfection Spirits is probably the most anti-meta route that you can go, because it's like a lockdown deck and you just try and make sure that your opponent literally can't play the game. Which is not my favorite way of playing. I like interacting with my opponent, and literally permission decks are as the least amount of interaction you can get into a game of Yu-Gi-Oh! Because you're basically just saying no to everything your opponent does, and that generally is a really boring game. Also, however, Perfection Spirits is probably less consistent than most other builds of spirits, mainly because you can get a lot of combinations that don't work, so that you don't really have any plays that you can do. Like, the Spirit Engine kind of helps a little bit, because you can go into rank 4s and you can do cool stuff like that, because there are a bunch of really good rank 4s. But apart from that, like, if they stop that, and you can't get off your Ritual Summon in the first couple of turns, you're probably going to lose, just simply because you have a lack of playable cards in your deck. Also, it doesn't really use the spirits as effectively as a bunch of other strategies. Like, for example, you're never ever going to resolve a Nikitama by discarding it with Herald of Perfection, because the only way you can do it is if you normal summon for your turn Aritama, and then they are stupid enough to activate something, then you can finally get its effect off. But, like, you can. People argue that you can get it off in the deck using Izanami, and that's generally a true statement, but it's something you can do with all the other builds of spirits too, so I don't really get why that's valid. Also, I like that there are some things that I do like about the Herald of Perfection Spirit deck. Like, it uses a bunch of different ways of using spirits, like the fact that they're fairies really helps out with Christia, which is something that not a lot of spirit decks really focus on, the fact that there are a bunch of fairies that are spirits. And I think that's definitely very interesting. The other thing I like about the deck is the combo with Aritama, Nikitama, and Transmodify. Like, you go Nikitama, summon Aritama, and then you transmodify the Nikitama into a Tethys, and then you can draw some cards that way, because your Nikitama will draw, and then that will trigger your Tethys. Like, that's pretty interesting, but it's a little bit inconsistent. You have to... Well, you obviously are running a lot of fairies, so that's why it doesn't really work in any other build of spirits. But it just is not a very consistent draw engine, if you know what I mean. Like, it's like a very... It can get stopped really easily too, which kind of sucks. Which it means you have to have Herald of Perfection up first if you want to pull this off and have other spirits in your hand, but that's kind of beside the point. And... Yeah, I think that is very interesting, though. It's definitely a way of using Nikitama that I hadn't thought up yet, which is pretty cool. Thank you guys so much for watching the video. I'm sorry if this was kind of a brash way of saying that I don't like Herald of Perfection in any way. It's very true. It's, like, not a very fun deck to play. I have played it before. I played it back when you had like wave motion cannons and stuff like that, and there weren't a lot of outs to Herald. So you could just be very obnoxious, stall for 8 turns and win. Like, that was kind of bullshit. But let me know what you guys think of Herald Perfection Spirits in the comment section down below. Maybe I'm wrong, and it is the best way of playing Spirits and Herald of Perfection. But as far as I'm concerned, I just don't like the deck. And that's just how I feel. That's just how I feel.